Welcome to the second edition of the ICC Global Events Newsletter. Today we'll be speaking with Mike Gatting, England legend and current MCC president, about what's in store for the coming months. And we'll also look ahead to the Cricket World Cup in Australia and New Zealand.
Welcome, Mike. Now, we've just had two test matches, but what an unbelievable series between England and Sri Lanka. Were you surprised at how close it actually was?
No, not really, because, I mean, England probably just lacked a little bit of confidence coming into this, having had a very rough winter. And there were two very important people that were probably going to have their last tours here, and being the type of people that I know they are, and the wonderful players are, that is Mahela Jayawardena and Kumar Sangakkara, two wonderful players who have been the cornerstone of the Sri Lankan side. And it was interesting for me. I mean, Angelo Matthews seems to have come on leaps and bounds as a player, and he really, for me, led with some conviction, but not only led with conviction, but also with the bat and the ball. He really performed extremely well. And add that to somebody, the sort of steady Hereth, who bowled some spin for them. They had four people there that really performed very well for Sri Lanka. And when you've got four people doing that, whatever test match you're playing in, it's going to be difficult to beat them.
India are here, of course. They'll be obviously disappointed with the performance that they put in last time they were here. 4-0 they lost. They've got a lot of talented youngsters coming in. A lot of guys that haven't actually played test cricket on English soil. How do you think they'll fare over here?
Well, again, I think there's a new era come through, isn't it? You know, yeah. Tendulkar's finally left the scene, and Dravid has left too. But, you know, Kohli seems to have come through, Pujara, Dhawan, you know, three really exciting players. And you add a little bit of experience like Gautam Gambhir to that, and one or two others of the all-rounder category, with Jadeja, who's going to bowl a bit of spin. Yeah. And, of course, the wonderful sort of enigmatic Dhoni, who's going to be keeping wicket and
hopefully
scoring runs and captaining.
We won't see him bowl this time at Lords.
No, we won't hopefully see him bowl this time at Lords, no. That was quite extraordinary, wasn't it, that he took the gloves off and had a bowl in a test match. But, that's something that I hope we don't see. But, no, they will have an opportunity, I think, again, with England boys perhaps not as confident as they might be. They have got some wonderful young players, as we always see coming through from India. And their seamers might be slightly more testing if they're going to be up to their standard with Ishant Sharma and Bhuvaneshwar, who's actually, to me, the one I'd like to see bowl, because he really would bowl well in English conditions. So, if England are going to say they're going to take Ashwin and Jadeja out of the sort of scene by playing on green wickets or non-turning wickets, then, I still think India will have one or two bowlers that could cause England problems.
Looking ahead to the Cricket World Cup, of course, in Australia next year, who do you think will be going through to the final? There's a lot of choices.
There are, and you've got to look at the hosts. I mean, look, you can put the three countries that have done so well. You've got Pakistan, India and Sri Lanka. And you'll say that they, with the players they've got and the history they've got, that they will always be in and around the finals. But then you've got to take into home sort of soil, and New Zealand are such a hard, McCullum and Jess Ryder and, just Southie, just people who they're on their own turf, they'll be on their own grounds, and they're always hard to beat. And then, of course, Australia.
Yeah.
They've got some wonderful, wonderful youngsters coming through. They've got some good, solid cricketers in there. And you just wonder, again, on their home soil, they're going to be hard to beat too.
Who was the toughest one-day player that you ever played against?
Oh, I think if you're talking about batsmen, then trying to get Viv out in a one-day match, I saw him probably play one of the most memorable matches or innings I saw at Old Trafford, when West Indies were 60 odd for six or something, and he ended up getting 180 odd in the sort of remaining sort of 35 overs, and they ended up getting sort of 290 or something, and it was just incredible. I mean, I think he got sort of 80, while Michael Holding got about 10, and it was just phenomenal. And he without doubt to me was he'd bowl you a few overs as well, but he could run somebody out as well, and just the aura and just the competitiveness of the man was quite incredible.
Hope you enjoyed this month's newsletter. Don't forget to check out the competition where you have a chance to win a fabulous trip to Australia. See you again next month.